In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create your very first Spring project and how to run it. So let's get started. For a Spring application, now you can download the full boilerplate of your application, that means the full framework for your specific application, from a website named start.spring.io. Okay, this is the URL. So you can go to this website and select the project dependencies, the language, the build tool, and the version of the framework and other metadata, and then download the framework and start building your software. The Spring initializer website, where we will download our website framework. For this scenario, let's consider we are building a software for Google, which will provide us the email service, just to imagine. Okay, so here, after visiting the website, we can see that the first menu is type of the project. The project here means the build automation tool. We have two options, Maven project or Gradle project. So Maven and Gradle both are build automation tool. They will organize your libraries and dependencies and will download them from a central server like Maven repository or something. So from that, I'm selecting the Maven project, which is already selected. And the second part is language. We have three different languages available for Spring: Java, Kotlin, and Groovy. So for now, I'm selecting Java. This is also already selected. And then we have to select the version of Spring Boot. Here we can see that there is a word named snapshot. So what does that mean? Snapshot means the version is not yet released, but this can be the version later. So here 2.6.0 means this is not actually 2.6.0, but eventually this version can be 2.6.0. So I'm not going with this. So this is just a plain 2.5.6, means this tested and final stable version. So this is also previously selected. You can select a older version if you want to, which is 2.4.12. So this is default selected latest framework for Spring. I have selected Maven, language is Java, Spring Boot version is this one, the stable version, and here the project metadata is selected, com.example. So the group ID, what is group ID? Group ID is the main company you are building the software for this scenario. So since we are imagining we are building a mail service for a company, let's say ABC, not Google, then we can set group ID to com.abc. So the convention here is putting the domain in reverse. So the website domain is abc.com. I'm putting the group ID as com.abc. So now what is the artifact? Artifact is the specific service we are building. Let's say we are developing the mail service for ABC company, then the artifact will be mail. Here the name, one thing about artifact is the name of artifact will be the name of your jar or wall file after you finish development and build the package for deployment. So this is important. So here I am naming the artifact as mail. The name of the software is the name of software. Pretty similar. So I'm not changing this. The description, I'm changing the description as description is mail service for ABC company, just for an example. So the package name is already been selected from the artifact and group ID. So this is com.abc.mail. Now here we found two options for packaging. One is for jar, another one is for var. So what is the difference between jar and var? Jar means Java archive, var means Java web archive. So if you are building a specific web application which will be deployed later in a server, that means the server is not embedded in your final build. In that case, you will select var. You will build the full application then you can deploy it on ClashFish or any Java server. But when you have an embedded server in your application, let's say you have embedded Tomcat in your application, then you should select jar and accept the scenario I have said about selecting var. In all other cases you should select jar. So after that, what is the version of Java? So I'm selecting the Java 17, which is the latest LTS version. So selecting this one. So from the beginning, we have selected everything for our specific application to download the framework. Now here we have selected no dependencies, but since it's a framework, we will be needing lots of dependencies. But for now, I'm only selecting two dependencies. One is the embedded Tomcat and another one is Java Spring Starter Web. So first one is Spring Web. This is for web development with Spring, and the second one is as you can see here, the Spring Web has the Apache Tomcat as the default embedded container. So we don't need to add a different server. So the dependency I was looking for is already in this dependency, Spring Web. So our project's metadata is provided, the version is provided, and I've selected the dependencies for now. And for the record, we can select our dependency whenever we want. We just need to put the information on this dependency on the Maven's XML file, pom.xml file later. I will explain this later, so don't worry about this. Just do this and then you are ready to download your customized framework. So here I'm downloading my customized web framework on my downloads folder and opening my IntelliJ. You can do this with your NetBeans or Eclipse or Spring Toolsuit, which one you prefer. But for now, I'm using IntelliJ. And after opening IntelliJ, I'm clicking on open since I have downloaded the file. So one important thing is I have to extract this since this is a compressed file. So I have extracted the file and now opening the folder on my Eclipse, clicking on open. And going to my download folder and selecting the pom.xml file so that ID can understand that this is a Maven project. So opening as project. So now the ID is loading my files and downloading the libraries and dependencies I need to for this project, which I selected there. So if I go to the project and expand it, under my source folder there are two folders, main and test. Main is for main development code and test. Main is for main software feature and test is for test. And if I expand the main, I can see that two folders, Java and resource, both are very important folder. In resource folder we have application.properties and other thing, and in our Java folder we have a package named mail, com.abc.main, which we provided for this application domain. So if I open the mail application, then we can see that the main Spring class. So this is the main method where the Spring application start every time you run it. So I'm not going to this in details, I'll explain this later. And for the very first time, if I want to run this on the ID, I can add my configuration from here. But if I run this file for the very first time, since this is containing my main method, then the ID will automatically capture the main method and save it for later. Now I'm running my project, the boilerplate I have just downloaded for my mail service application. and the application is running. As you can see, it's showing on the screen. My application just started. So my embedded Tomcat is started on 8080. So if I go to localhost slash 8080, then I should be able to send the request to my Spring server for now. So guys, this is the boilerplate of your Java application. In the next tutorial, I'll explain the application.properties file and the pom.xml file so that you can understand how to configure the project and how to have new dependencies for development. So thank you guys for watching. If you have any confusion or face any problem, you can let me know in the comment. I'll be happy to answer. And if you have learned something from this video, I'll appreciate if you like the video and hit the subscribe button for future video. That means a lot to me. That motivates me to make more helpful content. Thank you once again.